it's critically important to know where Serbia is today in 2013, I would say where Serbia wants to be in 2020. I think this is basically the vision that this regional policy should give to Serbia in that overall context. It's not easy because you need to match how you want to see Serbia looking in 2020 with the different line ministries and sectoral policies, transport, energy, education, that have been met. So we need to, in a way, put all this policy into a coherent framework. This is, I think, all the efforts that has been done today. Let me give a practical example. If you build a business zone today in Vranje, you need to make sure that not only you have the business zone created, but that there is connected to infrastructure, to the Corridor 10. You need to make sure there is energy available. You need to make sure also that the workers will be properly trained, educated to do the work that is expected from them. You need to create an environment with education, health, so that the companies would invest in that area. So you see, very practically, you need to have a global vision on where you want this development to happen. And I could say examples in Užice or in Pirot for the same purpose. So I think this is the big challenge that we are embarked into. So not just from the ministry and the different sectoral ministries, but also from the local actors. The local actors also need to bring their contribution, their vision, and we need to match, let's say, this vision from the top with the expectations from bottom up, what the local authorities want to do in this respect. So it's a big effort that we will engage now in the 6 months to come. The ministry is in the lead, I think, to establish this vision, and we expect all the actors, the line ministries, the local authorities, to participate within this effort and process.